Hey you guys, it's Peter, and welcome to my channel, Peter Likes Books. Okay, today I am going to do a full spoiler-free review of Wendy Walker's Emma in the Night. And I started this year out saying that I was going to do a full review of every book that I read in the year of 2017, which as of today would be 51 books. Oh my God. 49 away from my goal of 100. But what happened over time, and I did keep it up for a while, I did like 10 or 12 reviews, was that those videos got, you know, like so many less views than my other videos, which is fine. You know, I don't make the videos for the views, but what it told me was that people don't really want to see reviews of a book, is what I thought. And then what was interesting was the same people over time kept on asking me for reviews, and they would say, you know, based on your reviews, I go and buy books. The other night, I received a message on Goodreads, and it was, I really needed to hear it. Every time when I'm done with a book, like immediately, as soon as I'm done with a book, I pull up my Goodreads, and I post on there whatever I feel about the book, like in one sentence or two, and then I say, check out my full review on my BookTube channel, Peter Likes Books. I have now changed that because I can't remember who it was, but she said, I can't find your full review. Well, I stopped doing full reviews, so when I say that, I just basically mean like in my wrap-ups and things like that. But then I started thinking like, should I go back and do full reviews? I had just done a full review of John Green's Turtles All the Way Down. Part of the problem is, although all of us, you know, are very opinionated readers, we sometimes don't like when other BookTubers that we like or don't like have different opinions than us about books that we love or don't love. So sometimes reviews are not super popular for that reason as well, if that makes sense. But you know, I thought I'm gonna start doing reviews, not on every book, but on books that I feel really moved to talk about or books that I think are very, very important. And I can tell you, going in to Emma in the Night by Wendy Walker, I definitely did not think this would be a book that I would feel so moved to do a review about. So I now have changed, and on Goodreads it says I will be posting my full review on BookTube. But anyway, so I changed that because I do feel bad about that. But anyway, I started Emma in the Night two nights ago. I listened to it on Audible, and I did it because I read it because somebody recommended it to me in the comment sections of one of my videos. And they said, if you like kidnapping stories, you're gonna really like Emma in the Night. And I love kidnapping stories, you guys know that. So I went and I was on Audible, and I was like, it was like in my wish list already. And so I was like, well, I'm just gonna buy it now. So I bought it. I literally finished it in like a day and a half, not even. I thought it was a young adult book, and I have a feeling that it may still be categorized as a young adult book, but it's really not a young adult book. It isn't a young adult book in the same way that it pisses me off every time I go to the young adult section at Barnes & Noble or Half Price Books, and The Girls by Emma Klein or Dumplin' by Julie Murphy are in the young adult section. They're not young adult books. They just aren't, okay? They're adult books written about young adult characters, written about teenagers, but there's a difference to me. And you know, I feel like it has a lot to do with the mindset and all that kind of stuff. Emma in the Night, I think, is a book that teenagers could read, but it is very much an adult book. And especially at 45 years old, having, you know, grown up with a mother who I adore, but also had a lot of mental health issues, and I've talked a lot about that on all of my channels, this book was fantastically researched, extremely well written, and I thought so interesting. And the issue that it addresses is narcissistic personality disorder, and it's so well done, and there is not any other book out there that I have read or seen that does it in such a calculated and manipulative way. It is so beautifully written. So let me tell you what the book is about. Emma in the Night is about these two sisters, Cassandra, Cass, and Emma. Emma is 18 and Cass is 15 at the time, that they are missing, and nobody knows where they are. When the book starts, Cass returns home, and it's basically her story of where they've been for the last 3 years and why Emma is not with her. And also in this is this ensemble cast of this narcissistic mother and her current husband, ex-husband, half-brothers, step-brothers, and then the most fantastic character of all, this police detective, who I think is also like a psychologist, she is a psychologist, is Abby. Dr. Abby, I think her name is Wilson in the book, and she has like done her dissertation on narcissistic personality disorder, and she has a history of it in her own family, and I'm not spoiling anything for you because this all comes out very quickly in the book. It is so beautifully woven. I had no clue where this book was going. I can tell you that there are several times in the book, it's one of the most fantastic suspense mysteries I've ever read. There were several times in the book where I really thought, okay, this is what's going to happen, or I know where it's going, even right down to like the last 20 pages. I thought, okay, this is what's going to happen. I thought I had it all figured out, and I just didn't. And it was just so well done. I am so amazed that this book is not getting more acknowledgement than it is. Even if you take away the mental health aspect of how well it's written about narcissistic personality disorder, and if you take away, you know, how well it's woven together as a mystery, it is just a really fun, interesting read. And the main character of Cass is just somebody that you will never forget, I promise you. You know, I don't know that it's one of those books that had this huge, profound effect on me, that 10 years from now, I will be like, oh my God, I was changed by, Emma in the Night. But it's definitely a book that I identified with because of my own family history. And it's also a book that I can tell you right now, when somebody, and I recommended it to my friend Tanya last night. I said, Tanya, you've got to read this book, Emma in the Night. You will love it. And she loves mysteries. It is definitely a book at the top of my list, up there with Girl on the Train, Girl in the Red Coat, All Into the Water, all of those Paula Hawkins books and other books like that, that when somebody says to me, tell me a fantastic thriller, I will say Emma in the Night. I love you guys, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye.